Previously on After Prison Show.
Hey, look, you ain't gonna keep messing with this dude. I don't know him. Oh, he got them type of charges? Get him. Get you on your own stick. Yo, what the Speaking of doing videos based on the comment section, request from you guys down in the comment section. There's been a couple of people who have commented recently asking me, what in the world is that? Boy, that's the biggest mosquito. Bing! Boy, hey, you better back up. I just got my COVID vaccine. I'm not trying to go get me that West Nile one. Shit, where did it go? I've been doing a lot of videos based out of the comment section as of late. Shout out to each and every one of you guys. I've really enjoyed getting back to the prison content. Hey, we are going to stick with the prison content. And in terms of flip house or vlog videos, I'm going to start a new channel for that. Breaking news, new channel on the way. I'll be sharing that with you guys probably this week. But there's been a lot of comments asking me to address something that, like, this dude, EDP-445, I've got no idea. Like, I didn't even know what this was. I thought it was like an ED pill, like erectile dysfunction type of thing. I had no idea what this was. Well, I would do a little bit of research on this, find out that it's not a pill, it's a dude. Maybe that's like his video game profile username. I got no idea, but get ready to back the prison bus up, pick this dude up, and cart his ass off to the penitentiary, because there's a high likelihood that that's where this dude is going to end up going, and he definitely deserves to go there because people doing exactly what he's done have ended up there. We're going to talk about all of that in this video, and most importantly, what will EDP 445 be like in prison? I got a microphone right there. I know that looks super suspect when I'm going. I know. A lot of you are probably wondering, Joe, who in the F is EDP 445? I was just as dumbfounded to who this person was as many of you may be. It'll be my hope to try to bring you guys up to speed right now. It's this guy, right here, who I guess is known on the internet as that crazy Eagles fan. He's supposedly become the face of a lot of memes on Twitter. I've never seen this dude before. And that's crazy because, again, when I go look this dude up, especially on YouTube, I noticed that this dude has 2.2 million subscribers. And his videos, I guess, are somewhat about like Eagles. And I saw a video of him doing a mukbang, eating two pizzas, like 2.2 million subscribers. Like, what? Like, what? I don't know. Now, EDP 445 stands for Eat Da 445. Like, I don't. And, you know, when you think about what I'm getting ready to share with you guys, that just hits so much different with what's going on with this dude. We'll go ahead and share a headline with you guys to go right up into this thing. YouTuber EDP445 caught allegedly trying to meet with a 13-year-old girl. Yo, why do YouTubers be doing this type of shit? But I guess it's not just YouTubers. I mean, you got some sicko, pedo type of people up in this world. Now, this is a grown-ass man we're talking about right here, this EDP445 dude. And, you know, the allegedly part of this, I'm having a tough time latching onto because I think it was just this past weekend where there's this group on YouTube, or maybe this channel on YouTube, known as Chet Goldstein. And it was these dudes that basically exposed the whole mess out of this EDP445 dude, basically setting him up, exchanging messages with him, acting as if, you know, they were some underage, super underage female. Then met up with this dude, confronted this dude, on camera this dude. What they call this is, they call it caught in 4K. Now, I'd never heard about this. I know, Joe, like, what? I'd never heard about this until this situation right here when I did a lot of digging and, you know, trying to get up to speed on all of this. But yo, catching them in 4K means, I guess it means like, yo, they catch you for reals. in 4K clarity, like all of the facts are right there. Boom, they got you. They got you dead to rights as such with this dude right here. They confront this dude on a live stream. And I think that there's a video coming, or it's already came, you know, by the time you guys are seeing this video, of this whole confrontation, the clips that they've shown of this, and like I said, there was a live stream, so maybe all of that was already out there via the live stream. But the clips that I've seen, they asked this dude, yo, are you here to meet a 13-year-old girl? This dude is like, yes. Are these your messages? Yes. Like, there is no denying it. Dude knows he's caught. Now, before any type of rebuttal or defense could ever be mustered up for this dude, there's none that can be. Because this is not the first time that allegations like this have been brought up against this particular dude. In fact, it was just last year where somebody had set him up and acted as a 17-year-old girl up in his DMs. And, you know, he was talking very illicitly to this minor. And they put him on blast, and he addressed this in a video. I think the video was called These Accusations. Now, I've watched this video. And, you know, he's just denying this whole situation. If you think that I'm a pedo, you're getting high, you're sniffing cocaine, that's his excuse. He's cussing and carrying on the whole time in this video. Like, it just seems like it's not, there's no excuse to this type of behavior, and that this dude is definitely a pedophile. You know, they say that it's not just these two times neither. And in fact, there's a person by the name of Cold Raven on YouTube. I watched one of his videos. And he seems to be a huge Ravens fan. And there is some kind of history between him and this EDP 445 dude where I think Cold Raven tried to expose this dude in the past, saying that it was like 8 times that this dude has been caught in these DMs with minors. And when Cold Raven, who was a smaller YouTuber, brought up these allegations against this dude, it probably looked like he was just trying to clout chase or something like that. Yo, the dude EDP 445 came back. And his rebuttal caused all of his fans to bring all of this hate toward this Cold Raven dude. Well, look at this Cold Raven dude now. He's just made a response video basically saying, I told you so. It was from his video that I learned, and go check out his video as well. It was from his video that I learned that the last time or the last people who got charges brought up against them because of predator poacher ended up getting 10 years in prison. Now also, think about Austin Jones. Austin Jones got 10 years in prison, another YouTuber who got caught up in the DMs, messaging and requesting sexually explicit videos from minors. I don't know the extent of what this EDP 445 dude has done, but you gotta think, if there's 8 allegations, if there's this caught red-handed thing, you gotta imagine that this rabbit hole is probably pretty damn deep. I'll share with you guys a little bit of this story. There's a couple of stories. There's tons of videos on this particular dude. YouTuber EDP445, you might recognize as the Crazy Eagles guy. I don't, I'm sorry. From countless memes, has been caught allegedly trying to meet up with a 13-year-old girl by a group who call themselves Predator Poachers. EDP, real name Brian Moreland, has over 2 million subscribers on YouTube and has become the face of countless reaction memes online. If you're a regular on Twitter, I am. You've likely seen his face before. I haven't. Now, though, a group on social media called Predator Poachers have released a video that featured EDP allegedly planning to meet up with a 13-year-old girl with multiple screenshots, messages, and videos of him at the scene. The group confronted EDP. He did not deny anything. On April 18th, Predator Poachers uploaded several screenshots and videos to their Instagram page exposing EDP's messages to a girl he believed to be 13, but it was actually them in disguise. After posting photos of EDP as well as vulgar screenshots of the messages exchanged between himself and who he believed to be a young girl, Predator Poachers shared a video questioning EDP, "You did double text here, correct?" Knowing she was 13, they asked him, to which he simply says, correct. Then, to be plain as day, they asked, so you initiated a conversation with a 13-year-old girl knowing she was 13, to which he confirms they are once again correct. You know, these conversations, and you can go see these conversations, they're just not good. Not the type of conversations you should be having with a minor, especially, I mean, you just never should have these type of conversations. Nobody, no grown person ever should. They say there's previous allegations against this dude. We've already talked about that. And they wrap this story up by saying, should these reports be accurate, we expect legal action heading EDP's way in the future. Folks, again, if you don't know who this dude is, I encourage you to stay up on this story because he's going to have to respond to this. Unless he's just going to hermit crab disappear, yo, they got me, they see the type of person that I am, he's going to have to respond. And if his response is anything like his last response to allegations similar, I'm going to be interested to see this shit show that it certainly will be. So what will this dude be like in prison? You already know they don't really like the SOs at all. You're probably going to have to be in PC. This is probably going to end up being a pretty high profile case, especially in the local area where he's at. I don't know where he's from. I think Philly. He's a crazy Philly fan. You're going to have a rough time in prison. It would be my hope at the very least. But then again, does what predator poachers, you know, caught this dude on constitute enough for criminal charges? Like I said at the beginning of this, I've seen people in similar situations end up getting locked up. Think about people on To Catch a Predator. You're getting locked up. Hey, what are you doing here? You're getting locked up. You're going to have a rough time. You a big dude too, so you know you like to eat. They're going to be taking all your shit. All your shit. Philly too? Philly got to be rough. Thinking about the way them Eagles fans are at them games. Is you going to be able to even watch any games while you locked up? Do they got a TV back there in PC where you're probably going to be at? What's the food going to be like? Ooh, imagine your reaction when they find out what you're locked up for. Hey, ain't you that dude? Erectile dysfunction, whatever. A 445. Oh, nah. Everything you got is mine. And you got a little bit of notoriety behind you. I wonder how R. Kelly's doing these days. He's actually probably doing not so bad. You know, and God forbid they find out you got any sort of money. Which, you know, from the reaction video, the response video that I watched from the previous allegations that were brought up against this dude. You know, one of the things he mentions is, you know, why would I do this? He's like, I just went out and bought a $60,000 car cash money. Why would I throw my life away? Don't let them find out you got some money. Your big ass is going to be getting extorted for real. Your big ass is going to lose some weight too. And I'm not sitting here trying to make fun of your weight because, you know, I'm a bigger dude. But, hey, sleep late, lose weight. Don't sleep on your belly if you don't trust your celly. Don't let him find out neither what you're up in there for. They're going to back the bus up on your ass, especially if there's any other kind of like really crazy messages between you and these alleged minors. Like I said, from the video that I watched by this guy, Cold Raven, he said the last people that predator poachers caught ended up getting 10 years. My God. You got any information on anybody out there? You know anybody up in the dope gang? You might need to cooperate. Tekashi made that okay. Shit, you might be able to start you a prison YouTube channel by the time it's all said and done. And like I incorporated at the beginning of this video, hey, look, you ain't gonna keep messing with this dude. I don't know him. Oh, he got them type of charges? Get him. Get you on your own stick. That skit right there from a previous video, kind of ironic that something like this would pop up right afterwards. And you know, sometimes when I do videos about people of certain notoriety, you know, I'll offer a prison consulting service to them. Hey, you know, if you need help getting prepared for prison, if you need help trying to get hard, and I'm not talking about the way your cellie's gonna be when he see you getting up out the shower, but, you know, I would usually offer the prison consulting to help prepare a person for prison, but not this. That just don't sit right with me. Got a feeling, man, you're gonna be in for a rough ride if criminal charges are brought up against you. If you guys have heard about this, let me know what your thoughts are on this. How much time do you think this guy is going to get? Do you think criminal charges are going to be brought up against him? And if you haven't heard about this guy before and you're just becoming familiar with him like I am, you know, also let me know what you guys think about this whole situation. I guess, you know, when you get that notoriety, when you get that little social media influencer status and them DMs start flooding in, yo, your ass better be careful. Don't get jammed up. Don't be an EDP or an Austin Jones or whoever, anybody else. I guess these predator approacher dudes really go after. Sometimes it seems people of notoriety on social media, but they probably go after just anybody in general. Let me know what you guys think about this situation. I'll be interested to hear what you have to say. And as always, until next time, enjoy life, the free world, never take a moment for granted, and make the most of every day. Peace!